The surgeon makes an incision in the lower abdomen on the right side, usually just above the groin area.
This incision provides access to the iliac fossa.
After the incision, the surgeon carefully dissects through the layers of tissue to expose the iliac fossa. This may involve moving aside muscles, nerves, and blood vessels. The surgeon identifies the external iliac artery and vein, which will be the recipient blood vessels for the transplanted kidney. The vessels are dissected and prepared for anastomosis in connection with the renal artery and vein of the donor kidney. The veins are connected via a longitudinal incision on the iliac vein, or a venotomy.
The parachute stitches technique is used to connect the veins. After the venotomy is completely secured, two vascular clamps are used to obtain proximal and distal control of the right iliac artery.
A punch incision is used to create the arterial anastomosis or connection. Again, the parachute technique for stitches is used to connect the arteries as well. The vascular clamps on the proximal and distal end of the iliac artery are removed. The area is washed thoroughly and observed for any bleeding from the arterial anastomosis or connection and the venous anastomosis or connection. The yellow tubular structure is the ureter. It carries urine from the transplanted kidney into the bladder.
A two-layer incision is made into the roof of the bladder or the dome.
A ureteral stent is passed from the bladder into the ureter through the anastomotic incision. The ureter is then connected to the bladder.
The bladder dome is now closed.
The closure begins layer by layer until the skin is closed. Best wishes for great health.
To learn more,
please visit thevirtualnephrologist.com.